For players whose goal is to compete at the collegiate level, the current recruitment landscape provides more challenges and obstacles than ever before. Due to the pandemic logjam in the college ranks and the upside of the transfer portal, prospects have to maximize the efficiency of their process to even have a chance. My name is Levi, and helping players open doors is what I love to do. For those with hoop dreams, your time is valuable, and what you choose to do with it is crucial. The odds are certainly stacked against you, and it's about time to prove them wrong.
Y'all wanna know why you don't stop? Y'all wanna know why you don't flop? Let me tell you people why. Came from the bottom of the block. When I was born, it was sworn I was never gonna be shit. Had to prove the opposite. I was bitch, had to get my ride on. Eyes on the prize, Sean knew I had to get these chips. Had to make moves like Elijah Wan. Started out selling down to Knicks. Graduated to a brick, no exaggeration. My infatuation with the strip. Legendary like a schoolboy. Crush a million in every chick. Heavy shit. That's how schoolboy got whipped and got left on some chest. Me, myself, and I on some true boy shit. Had to voice to a place up, to a place of no return. Had to play with fire and get burned. Only way the boy ever gon' learn. Had to lay way in the cut till I finally got my turn. Now I'm on top in the spot that I earned. It's my life. It's my pain and my struggle. The song that I sing to you is my everything. Treat my first like my last, and my last like my first, and my first is the same as when I came. It's my joy and my tears, and the laughter it brings to me is my everything. Like I never.
So who is Jonathan Hakim? John, in one word, man, he's a worker. John is absolutely a worker. He's a guy that, as a coach, when you get a chance to work with a player who everything that they do in regards to the game of basketball, all the extra time they put in, the great strength coaches he's working with, the great player development coaches he's working with, everything that John does involving the game of basketball is rooted with one purpose, and that is to be the best player that he can become. It's all driven by his love for the game. And when you get a chance as a coach to wade through all that other BS, to get past the different distractions or the optics or the ulterior motives, the different paths that are out there, when you get a chance to just focus with a guy and lock in on his dream of reaching his potential, it really is a gift as a coach. It's rare. It's rare when there's a chase, there's a fight, there's a battle that you are linked in together that is that pure, that is that distinct in terms of the finish line. And when you're able to cut through all of the other distractions, it really is, it's a special circumstance. John is by no means the most talented guy out there, but he is absolutely one of the hardest workers I've ever been in the gym with. I'm forever in this guy's corner because of his love for the game, his belief in himself, and who he is off the court. John's a great guy. I mean, an easy guy to like. He's a great teammate. I was fortunate enough to be his high school coach for a small period of time. And his impact on our culture, on our campus, in our locker room was something that was pretty special to see. But it's just how he carries himself, how he pushes himself. And he's a special kid. He's got some big goals that we're going to be chasing over the next few years. And although they won't be easy, I'm happy to stand, you know, on the front lines of that battle for him on a daily basis. No hesitation, no questions asked. wherever that kid is going, I'm riding with him. So as we get into this and we kind of learn a little bit about more about John and his story, I think you'll get to see, and ultimately we'll share the high valued opinion that we have of him as well.
John is a 6'4 wing that is going into his senior year, and although he's what you would consider a late bloomer whose best basketball is far ahead of him, there's one thing that he's always had a knack for from day one. He can flat out shoot the ball. And while he has adapted and enhanced his game over the years, luckily for us, he can still let it fly.
Pigeonhole, I'm a night out, it's a different mode. I'ma have to make a paint of six on a pinky toe. Heard you with a shooting guard, just let it know. I would have your court side, not the middle row. All good love in a minute though. I can't stress about no cause I'm a timid soul. Plus I'm cooking up ambition on the kitchen stove. Pot start to bubble, see the suds, that good to go. Damn suave, but I can't get Rico. Bro think he John Wayne, I bought them Yellowstones. Love the way they hang, babe. The silicone, everybody fake now. You could crack the code, bust down everything. Set in rose gold, dread talking to you like I'm J. Cole. I could tell her head good before I even know. Don't tell me that you model if you ain't been in Vogue. Gotta throw a party for my day ones. They ain't in the studio, but they'll lay some. Rest in peace to Drama King.
John's ability to shoot is what helps separate him from other prospects. He's a high-level spot-up threat who understands spacing in relation to the ball and has a quick trigger. He's one of those guys who seems to find the right place and right time consistently to get open looks off. He also has a good feel when it comes to off-ball movement. He sets up his cuts and screen angles, always looking to create an advantage for himself or others as he navigates away from the ball. He has a tireless work ethic where he wears defenders down over time by staying on the move. He's gifted at picking and popping, setting drags, and setting slides as he has the ability to gather his balance while moving either direction and squaring up to the rim. When you combine his height and his ability to move off the ball, it's easy to see why he gets a lot of high-quality shots off. From an on-ball perspective, he's starting to gain some rhythm there as well with his face-up ability. He likes to utilize jab steps and pump fakes to create openings. His shot creation is also growing. He's still at his best when he keeps it to 2 to 3 bounces or less. Now defensively, John makes an impact in spite of his limited athleticism because he understands rotations and he competes at a high level every possession. He's a willing and active help defender who puts his body on the line for his team. The upside with John and the reason why he's got a chance to play at the next level is simple. He can make a positive impact in any offensive system. Are you running a primarily spacing-based offense that utilizes a lot of ball screens? John can make an impact by spacing off the ball, helping you capitalize when defenders are in a scramble, or punishing a third defender for tagging on a roll. He also brings the ability to pick and pop himself and can help you stretch the defense that way. Are you running more of a motion-based offense with off-ball screens and cuts? John is actually at his best moving off the ball and sizing up his quick release. He's more than willing to set real screens and help create an advantage for a teammate. In a nutshell, he's a great perimeter threat who minimizes mistakes by playing towards his strengths and competes defensively on a regular basis. So how do we navigate this recruiting landscape? With the transfer portal and the pandemic logjam, college basketball is the Wild West these days, with a lot of talented players still searching to find a home. John is currently receiving interest from NAIA and Division III schools as he goes into his senior year, but the task of making it to the next level is as daunting as ever. So what is a kid with a dream to do? The same thing that it takes to accomplish any goal. You have to be willing to be vulnerable for your dreams. You have to be willing to fail for your goals. You have to be willing to risk putting your all into something without the promise of a return. Your love for the game has to overcome your fear of the optics. Only then can you reach your potential. Only then do you have a shot. When it comes to John's journey, the one thing that I do know is at the end of it all, he will be proud of the process. He will be proud that he left everything out on that court.
Wait, please don't let me just get the 808. as I hit the kill switch. Now that's how you let the beat build, beat.